Bill, what are you looking for?
We got a turkey, we got some potatoes, we got some carrots, and we got some squash.
Sounds like Thanksgiving to me.
Let's get cooking!
I'm Tom,
it's my friend Bill,
and today we're going to show you how to do Thanksgiving right.
Oh, Thanksgiving, one of the greatest times of the year. You get the turkey and all the amenities, all just rumbly and tumbly.
Oh yeah, I love it.
But speaking of rumbly and tumbly, I don't know, the bird takes a couple hours to cook and I'm feeling pretty hungry now.
That's because you're a little fat, Bill.
Well, at least my face isn't stupid, Tom.
Yeah.
So, let's make a snack.
Alright, what are you in the mood for?
Garlic bread.
I like garlic bread.
Hey, look. Go grab me that loaf of bread that's conveniently off the side of the stage.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. And to that, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of basil. About 3 tablespoons of garlic, depending on your taste.
Yep.
Half a stick of butter. And a quarter of a cup of Asiago. Quarter of a cup of Asiago. I'm fat. I like cheese. Half a cup of Asiago. Should be about a cup of mozzarella, I prefer, but Asiago works just as well. It's got a nice sharp flavor.
Yeah, well, that whole cup of cheese thing, again, I don't want to look like you.
Thanks, buddy.
No problem.
All right, well, we're going to clear some room here, so I'm going to move the turkey out of the way. And now we're going to get all the ingredients and move them off to the side.
Well, we've got a fresh loaf of Italian bread here. The first thing we're going to have to do is slice it down the middle.
All right, now that Tom's cut the bread, we can make our butter spread. So the first thing we're gonna do is take our butter, mix it into the bowl, mash it up really nice so it gets nice and tender and easily spreadable. I'm gonna add the garlic, mix that in really good. And last, we're gonna add the basil, because dry ingredients usually go last. And there we go, we'll mix that in nice. There we go. All right, now that that's mixed, we're ready to spread it on the bread.
All right, now that Bill's made the spread for us, we're going to take it, spread out evenly across both pieces of bread, and since he's so generously doubled the amount of cheese we're going to use, we have a quarter cup to put on each piece now. Bill...
What?
Anyway, let's get back to what we were trying to do before Bill had a little snack attack here. Take our spread. It's gonna be nice and tasty.
Oh, it takes like 7 minutes to cook.
Bill, it's 7 minutes. We'll survive.
Oh, I want it now.
I'm sorry, I can't change the laws of physics, but... Can you hand me the cheese?
Yeah.
One for one. One for the other. Yeah, it's a good thing you doubled that cheese. This works a lot better.
Can we put some more on?
No.
Oh.
All right. Now it's ready for the oven. Now that we're all set, we're gonna put it into the broiler in the oven for a couple of minutes. And when it's done, we'll have a snack. Nice and tasty. If I can get it out of the oven. There we go. So now that we've got a snack for us to munch on while we're doing all this, let's get started on the turkey. Bill, can you grab me a beer real quick?
You're such the alcoholic.
First off, one, I'm not an alcoholic. Alcoholics go to meetings. And secondly, thanks for eating all the garlic bread. I didn't even get a slice. Now I'm gonna have to go cut up the other half of the loaf.
Well, I got you a beer. Let me get you a bottle opener.
Don't worry. I got it.
You really are an alcoholic.
Well, yeah.
now that Tipsy McStagger's all sauced up, let's get started on the turkey.
Alright, now, we're starting with a 12-pound bird today. To make a glaze and get the turkey all set, we have some honey. We've split it into two parts. It was an 8-ounce container to start with. Some oranges, some sage, and some salt and pepper. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is put some salt and pepper on the bird to season it. We're going to put a layer of honey over it to start with. We've preheated our oven to 450 degrees because we're going to sear the bird. And we've raised it up off the bottom of the pan so it doesn't burn.
Next, we're going to make the second half of our glaze. And to do that, we're going to take our oranges, cut them in half, and squeeze them into a bowl to get the juice out. Now, we don't really want to go overboard with it because some of the juice has to stay in the orange because we're taking the half oranges when we're done and putting them inside the bird to preserve some flavor. And after the orange juices have been squeezed, we're going to put some honey in, put a little bit of sage, mix it up, and there's the rest of our glaze.
We're going to take the oranges that Bill just squeezed here and stuff them into the bird. Give a little more moisture to the bird on the inside, plus give some really intense flavor throughout.
Bill, you're such a pervert.
Alright, now that the bird has come out of the oven after 15 minutes, it's nice and seared, we're going to lower the temperature of the oven down to about 325 and take the rest of the glaze that we made earlier and pour it all over the bird.
Time to start on the mashed potatoes. What we're going to need for this is about 3 pounds of red list potatoes already chopped up. We're going to need some shallots, about half a cup of babybella mushrooms, some heavy cream, some butter, and if you're feeling a little alcoholic, some sherry.
Alright, look Surly, I know you like your booze, but it's not going to add anything to these potatoes.
You're right. Oh well.
Alright, now that the potatoes have been cut, we're going to put them in a pan and cover them with cold water and add just a little bit of salt. We'll put them on top of the stove and bring them to a boil on high. Once they come to a boil, we'll turn it down to low or simmer, which is about 1 or 2 on most stoves. And we'll steam like that for about a half hour, depending on the cut and size of your potato. You can tell they're done when you squeeze them in a ton and they fall apart.
So, to add to the potatoes, we're going to make a little bit of sauce and give it a lot of flavor. Now, if I were snooty and French, we wouldn't be calling this stuff cell sauce. But I'm not snooty. Or French. To make this sauce, we need our shallots and our mushrooms. I'm going to saute them up in the pan with the butter. Add a little salt and pepper just to give it some seasoning. Then we're going to move it over to the blender. Add some cream. Blend it up. And when the potatoes are all done being mashed, mix it all together. It's delicious.
Tom, I hate mushrooms.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sobby Mickey Ewo Pants. If you don't like it, why don't you go write about it in your live journal? Bye.
That's okay, because in Duxelles sauce, the mushrooms and the shallots get blended together with a little bit of salt and pepper. You really can't tell that they're there. And even people who don't like mushrooms tend to like Duxelles sauce. Alright, now that the mushrooms are done, I'm going to use a little bit of my beer here Throw it in the pan to deglaze it and get all the good bits up off the bottom that are sticking a little bit.
Drunk.
And then we're going to take the pan off heat and let it cool before we mix it with the cream, because we don't want the cream to curdle while we put it in. Now to finish off the potatoes, we're going to take our cream and our shallot and onion mixture that we made earlier, put it in the blender, mix it up till it's pureed into happy goodness. And we're going to throw it right into the pot, mash it up, everything will be all set. Potatoes are good to go.
Damn. All the goodness stuck at the bottom. Oh yeah. Oh, my baby. Yeah, yeah, mash. Mash it up.
So, while Tom was busy making his ducky sauce...
Duxelle sauce.
While Tom was busy making his ducky sauce, I was cutting up the squash for our next course. I cut up one butternut squash, one acorn squash, a couple of green apples, three or four, and I got a couple of other ingredients, too. Oh, we got some sugar, brown and white. We got a little bit of ground nutmeg, some cinnamon, and some olive oil. Now, it's not extra virgin olive oil, because that would add a little too much flavor to the piece. So, we're just using it to keep the vegetables from burning while they're in the oven.
Thanks, Bill. You get the stuff to make the carrots now?
Why, are your legs broken?
No, I don't feel like taking the hike around you to get to the fridge. There.
Fine.
Alright, now the Bill's out of the way.
Hey!
We're gonna put the squash together. We're gonna put the olive oil, the cinnamon, the nutmeg, and both sugars into the bowl and whisk them together. And then we're going to toss in the apples and the squash and mix them in by hand. It'll keep the fruit and the vegetables from getting bruised, plus it's a lot more fun.
That's what she said. Yeah, makes it. Yeah, you like that. Hey.
All right, now you need to put it into a sheet pan or a small Pyrex dish or whatever you can get that you can spread it out on, and throw it in the oven at 350 degrees. Or if there's space in the oven with your turkey, you can put it at 325 for a little bit longer.
That's what she said. Lush.
Fat.
Turkey go.
Now about 35 minutes passed, our squash is pretty much done. We're gonna pull it out of the oven, throw it in a bowl, and it's all set for dinner. Oh yeah, that looks delicious.
And now, carrots and raisins. Yay, carrots. So what you're gonna do is take about a pound of baby carrots and mix them in a saute pan with half a stick of butter and 2 tablespoons of sugar.
Half a stick, Bill? That's way too much.
Oh, I don't know. I think half a stick's about right. What do you think?
Hey, Bill? You're fat.
You're an alcoholic.
Oh, it's a good thing I brought the wine for dinner then, huh?
Well, I was just going to use white grape juice, but, oh well. Once the wine comes to a boil, lower the heat until about 2 or 3 on most stoves and let it simmer until the carrots are tender. It should take about 10 minutes or so.
next thing we need to do is make some stuffing, which in our case is actually dressing, because it's not inside the bird, but we're gonna call it stuffing anyway because everybody has stuffing at Thanksgiving. Now, Bill used our bread that we were gonna use for the stuffing to make some garlic bread, and I'm getting pretty close to happy hour, so we need a solution to get us out of here quick. Is our solution.
That is it. I am tired of this store-bought stovetop in my kitchen cabinet.
Controller is a full clip in my send a jacker into a coma. Girl, you ain't on crazy like crazy. Bone just tryna bone, ain't tryna have no babies. Ride clean as hell, so I pull in ladies. Laws are patrolling, you know they hate me. Your music turn all the way up into the maximum. I got speakers, try to jack for some, but we packing something and what we have for we have a locked up in the maximum. Security cell, I'm gripping old. Music loud and I'm tipping slow. Twin steady twisting like hit this dough. Behind and it's in his throat. Windows down, gotta stop pollution. City changed, like who is that producing? That's the plan skills when we out and cruising. Got warrants in every city except Houston, but I still ain't losing.
They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling.
Well, now that the obligatory violence is out of the way, let's make some stuffing. Tom?
Now that the stovetop's destroyed, we're gonna have to make some stuffing. We've got some cubes of bread. Some chicken stock, onion, celery, and bacon. Basically, we're going to take cubes of bread, pour the chicken stock over it, mix in the onion, the bacon, the celery. Throw it in the oven at 350 for about half an hour or so. And then, bada boom, bada bing, we've got dinner. Hey, Bill, you know what?
What's that?
In the process of doing all this, I forgot about the cranberry sauce.
All set, my friend. It's the centerpiece of our table.
Wow, Bill, that's amazing. It looks like it just came out of the can.
I sculpt cranberry sauce. Didn't you know that?
No, I didn't. That's amazing.
That it is. Well, this is a pretty successful Thanksgiving dinner. So, I think for now, I'm Bill.
I'm Tom.
Eat.
Drink.
And be merry. Well, now that Tipsy McStagger is all sauced up, let's start on the turkey. Alright, look, I know you need to dwarf this room. Damn it.
Oh, what?
So, I have one butternut squash and one acorn squash. You can edit that later, right? You want to just do the whole thing again? That's what she said. What are you doing? You got nothing on me. Yeah, on my face.